Welcome back. We are still with Camarines Sur Governor El Rey Villafuerte, and our followers on Twitter have some questions for you, Governor, so let's read some of them. Fonsi's dad says, El Rey's 2010 Sal-N revealed biggest jump in assets and most acquisitions were done during his incumbency. Is this true, and can we get a reaction?
That's not true because my Sal-N decreased. People probably have not realized before I became governor, mm-hmm. I was an entrepreneur and businessman. Mm-hmm. We were one of the biggest export companies in the Philippines. You had an office in China, in the States. I was awarded as a 10 outstanding young men in the Philippines for entrepreneurship. Mm-hmm. If you will look at my Sal-N in 2004, which was over 200 million, and now, nag-decrease pa. Mm-hmm. So that's a complete lie.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and another one from the same Twitter follower, the National Nutrition Council report says Camsur is the most number of malnourished children in Bicol. What have we done to address this?
Actually, we've reduced malnutrition by 45% according to the National Nutrition Survey. In fact, they're saying now na bumaba kami. Mm-hmm. That survey is a survey. If you do not comply, you will have a poor rating. And based on the Early Child Care Development Act, ang basic dapat mag-attend sa nutrition are the municipalities in the barangay. Mm-hmm. But in Camarines Sur, since merong pagkukulang ang mga munisipyo at barangay, kami lang po ang probinsya sa buong Pilipinas na may nutrition program sa lahat ng barangay sa buong Camarines or 1,036. So kami po hindi nagpapabaya maski hindi namin responsibilidad directly ang nutrition.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay, Wimpy Kid, parang it reminds you of somebody, ba? Wimpy Kid asks, totoo ba na katatakbo si Aga Mulak as Congressman of Camsur? Yeah, we wanted to talk about the personalities. Is Aga Mulak?
Yes, well, we're waiting for his formal announcement. Based on our talks, he's really running. Mm-hmm. He's been around, he's going around Camarines Sur the past 5 months. Mm-hmm. He was there from July 1 to 12 days. He's doing well in the surveys. People are accepting him. And the battle cry in that district is Porbara ng Bago.
Ano yung ibig sabihin?
Because the incumbent congressman there has been in power for 104 years. Mm-hmm. So they're saying, ano ba naman subukan natin tatlong taon kay Agam Mulak?
Okay, so Agam Mulak is running in the fourth district against Wimpy Fuentebella. Mm-hmm. Okay, actually si John Reyes naman is inuunahan na tayo sa susunod nating discussion, but I think he's excited. How's your relationship with your dad? Is Villafuerte versus Villafuerte gonna happen come 2013? Okay, and let me just lay the groundwork for this question because, as you mentioned, there was a Senate hearing, and that Senate hearing became very well known because of your clash with your dad over the creation of a new district. And now there are talks that although you will be running against Dato Arroyo, you're fielding your son against your dad.
Well, first of all, I would like to make it clear on record that I love my father. He's my idol. He taught me everything in politics. He was the one who endorsed me in 2004. He said, vote for El Rey Villafuerte, my son. Mm-hmm. He will continue my programs. He will continue my legacy, which I have done. Mm-hmm. Ang pamilya po ng mga Pilipino ay talagang hindi mo maiwasan may tampuhan. Mm-hmm. Ang mag-ama, magkapatid, mag-asawa. But ako, I believe in the end, beyond politics, magkakaisa rin kami. Mm-hmm. I think matatapos to, maayos rin tong tampuhan namin outside of politics. Mm-hmm.
But of course, the question now is, and because this has already been mentioned in the past, ano, that your son, Miguel, who'll turn 24 next year,
yes,
is going to run against his lolo, your dad, for governor of Camarines Sur. So how is this shaping up?
Two years ago, I asked my father if he wants to run for governor. He said he will not run anymore because of his age. He would want to, you know, just relax, enjoy his farm, and maybe run in a municipality as mayor. Mm-mm. But things have changed. Now he wants to run for governor. Mm-mm. But I believe in the end he will still support my son. Why? Mm-mm. In 2007, he put up a candidate against me. Mm-hmm. In the end, he supported me. Mm-hmm. In 2010, he put up a candidate against me again. And in the end, he supported me. So I believe he will give his apo, Miguel, a chance. Mm-hmm. Ang sabi nga, di ba, ang pag-asa ng bayan, mga kabataan. Palagay ko naman papagbigyan niya ang mga bata to lead the province. And modesty aside, I've done well for the province. I've continued all his programs. Dinagdagan ko pa. Mm-hmm. Palagay ko the young generation now should be given a chance to lead.
Mm-hmm. So historically, there have been times already in the past that you and your dad were at odds politically, but in the end, the two of you always reconciled.
Yes, that's what happened in 2007 and 2010.
But was that as bitter as this one now? Because you know, I read in the reports that there have been some very harsh words exchanged between the two of you.
Actually, hindi naman, kasi those same words were the ones thrown at me 2007. The difference between now and before is that it's now a national issue. Fit for me, nakalungkot lang.
Mm. Oh, because the split, the proposed split of the province has been elevated at the national level. Ano? So how does Miguel feel about potentially running against his grandfather?
Well, una-una malungkot siya. He's hoping and praying na his lolo will endorse him and eventually give way. Mm-hmm. To give the young generation, his apo, a chance. Mm-hmm. And my son is very much capable. He studied in the United States. He has a worldview. I feel that any leader now should have a worldview in governance.
Hindi rin siya marunong mag-Bicolano.
Hindi, very fluent.
Marunong. Okay, so that was also mentioned.
He's been going around the past a year and a half already. Mm-hmm.
Ever since he was a kid, he knows the dialect.
He learned that he can understand, but now mm-hmm. he can speak the language. Same with me. Mm-hmm. When I ran for governor, I basically can understand and I can speak a little Bicolano. But now, I'm very fluent.
Mm-hmm. So, you're saying that even on his own, for his part, si Miguel really wants to run also. It's not like that, I really don't want to go against my lolo, so hindi na lang ako tatakbo.
He asked me one day, he said, Dad, if you will give me a chance, I will would want to lead the province. I said, kaya mo ba? Sabi, kaya ko. Mm-hmm. And I believe the young generation can lead now with the internet now, mm-hmm. with the worldview of my son. With the experience, sabi ko nga, mas malaking probinsya, de dapat mas bata mag-lead.
Mm-hmm.
Kasi dapat mas masipag, may time, walang mm-hmm. asawa, anak ko. Mm-hmm. So his time can be dedicated to his job.
Walang asawa, walang girlfriend.
Meron. Not
okay,
now.
Okay. How is the rest of the family taking this? Yung feud nyo which is being played out in the media, on national TV.
Well, malungkot kasi everywhere I go, sinatanong, oy, Gob, bati na ba kayo ng father mo? Mm-hmm. So yun ang nakakalungkot doon.
Mm-hmm.
Nakakalungkot talaga. So yung immediate family ko, nalulungkot.
Your
mom? My mom, siyempre, naiipit dito.
Naiipit, yeah.
But I think magkakaisa rin kami.
So do you think this problem, this family feud would... don't you think that this would lessen your chances of being elected? The three of you, huh? In case your dad runs and your son runs. Hindi ba lalong makakasama itong
ganito? Hindi naman. Because my dad has been performing as congressman. I've been performing as governor. Mm-hmm. People elect based on accomplishments. Of course, nakakalungkot lang kung Villafuerte against Villafuerte.
Mm-hmm. But
I think in the end, they will elect who they think can really make the province prosperous, mm-hmm. kung sino makakatulong.
Mm-hmm.
Sa service, tumalabas, ang gusto namin elect kung sino talagang madaling lapitan at kung sino makakatulong sa kanila personally.
Mm-hmm.
So ako, I've, in modesty aside, in all most of the elections, I've always garnered the highest vote margins mm-hmm. in any political contest in Bicol region.
Mm-hmm.
I, in the last election, 2007, almost 300,000 ang lamang ko.
Mm-hmm.
Na-feel naman ng taong mga programa, and they know that Miguel, my son, will continue my programs and will add to my programs.
Mm-hmm. Perhaps, baka sabihin ng iba, hindi kaya mas mabuting i-split nyo na nga yung Camarines Sur para hindi na kayo
mag-iwahiwalay. Alam mo nakakalungkot, ang sabi ng father ko, wag na tayo mag-away, diyan ka na tumakbo. Lumipat na lang raw si Miguel sa kabilang district, doon sa province, dito na siya. Eh, ayaw ko naman kasi pangit naman yung nahatiin mo ang probinsya para sa personal na interest.
Mm-hmm.
So I think ang di namin pagkakaintindihan, ang disagreement namin is principled.
Mm-hmm.
Hindi naman siguro, kaya nakikita ng tao, kami, we're at odds because of the division, not because of a shallow reason.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so, well, we wish you all the luck, Governor.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining us tonight, and hopefully, all these differences will be resolved.
Yes.
Good luck for next year. Thank you.
Salamat. Thank you very much.
And up next, we will have a chat with Commissioner Rene Sarmiento of the COMELEC and former Senator Eddie Ilarde. Stay with us.